In this lesson, we are going to learn about gibbs free energy, which is represented by delta G Rxn. And sometimes the Rxn, which represent reaction, doesn't have to be written in the variables. So delta G represent gibbs energy. Notice the G right there. So what is it in the first place? It is the amount of energy in a reaction that can be used for work. And delta G is equal to minus NFE cells. First of all, N is the number of moles of electron in the equation or the reaction. And then F is the Faraday constant. Now this constant is 96,500 coulomb per moles of electron. So we can express it as a conversion factor. So keep in mind, a Faraday constant is a conversion factor as well. That is 96,500 coulombs, or coulomb is represented by the letter C, equal to 1 moles of electron. Lastly, we have the E cell potentials, which is the standard cell potential. Now, sometimes it has another name to it. It's called the standard cell voltage. Where's the voltage coming from? It's because of the V from the E cell potentials measured in volts. And volts is equal to joules over coulomb, which is right here. So this is joule, and this is coulomb. And joule is the unit of energies, of course. And coulomb is a unit of charge. So keep that in mind, because eventually you need to know what is coulomb used for and what's joules used for. So let's do an example problem. And how can we use the half cells to solve for delta G? First of all, our half cell is given to us into cathode and anode. So we know this is oxidation. So we have to flip this around, which give us Au equal to Au 3 plus, plus 3 electron. And most importantly, the delta E is now flipped. So we have negative 1.50 volt. So first of all, we need to know what is the number of electron that's involved. Since this Ag has one electron and this one has three electron, so we need to balance it out by multiplying this by 3. Given us the exchange of electron is 3, so therefore N is equal to 3. F is a Faraday constant, so it's given to us. And E cell, we can solve for E cells. E cell is equal to oxidation plus reduction. In this case, our oxidation is negative 1.50. And our reduction is 0.80. Give us negative 0.70 volt. So now we have our E cell. So let's plug into the formula. We have negative, and N is the number of moles of electron. In this case, it's 3. So we have 3. Notice how I don't write the unit mole for 3, because we are referring to the number of electron, not the actual measurement of electron in terms of mole. So that's why we use just the number 3, multiplied by F, or the Faraday constant, 96,500 coulomb over 1 moles of electron, time the E cell potentials. Notice how the Faraday constant is dealt with coulomb. So we have to convert our E cell potentials to in terms of joules and coulomb. So that way we can cancel out the unit. That would be negative 0.70 joules over coulomb. So we have negative 0.70 joule over coulomb. And notice how coulomb cancel out. And the rest is pretty easy. We just plug into the calculator and give us 202.650 joule over mole of electron. Since this is the unit of mole, and this is describing the chemical reaction, we can simplify this and just say in term of regular mole instead of specifically moles of electron. So we just have 202.650 joule over mole. So both of this could be the right answer. Let's try another problem where we have to calculate for the delta G's for the reaction. Again, we have the two half cells, anode and cathodes. But the E cell potential is given in reduction potentials. So this has to be oxidation, so this has to be the opposite of it. Negative 0.23. because this is positive. Then we calculate for E cells. So E cells, again, is equal to oxidation plus reduction. So we plug in the oxidation and reduction. We have given us negative 0.89 volt, which is equal to negative 0.89 joule over coulomb. We want this coulomb because the Faraday constant is in coulomb. Since F is a constant, which will be given to us, now that we only have to worry about N. If we look back at the half cell, this case we have 2 electron here for the cathode, but for the anode we have 4 electron. So we can say we can multiply this by 2. This will become 4 electron. So the electron cancel out. That means N is equal to 4. So let's plug in everything. We have delta G equal to negative N is equal to 4 times by the Faraday constant 96500 coulomb over 1 moles of electron times the E cell potentials or the standard cell voltage negative 0.89 joules over coulomb, and coulomb cancel out. Then we plug everything into the calculator. We have this, and notice how we have joules over 1 mole. Because this is the unit of mole, and it is describing a chemical reaction, this mole doesn't have to be moles of electron. It could be mole of any specific reactant or product or any specific substance in the chemical reaction. So keep that in mind. So our other answer could be like this as well. Notice how I don't have the electron there. It's just mole in general.